Have you heard the story of Ida Brown? Her legend haunts the entire town. She went mad with depression and lack of desire. Ida doused her home in gas and set it on fire. And if that may not sound sinister to you, what if I told you there were sleeping children inside too? Three little darlings, a girl and two boys. Their small faces melted, like plastic on their toys. Fire department was called. They took time to arrive. The chances were now null that they'd find them alive. People said the smoke killed them first, but who can be sure? They could have been conscious, searing agony most pure. Ida took her life with a gun before the cops came. The final straw sanity snapped from the weight of the shame. A few rooms survived, the children's mainly being affected. The debris was cleaned up, the home's items collected. An estate sale was held at the end of July. Townsfolk would drop in and find new things to buy. My uncle bought a toaster, not knowing it was cursed. The first time he used it, he ended up in a hearse. The buyers of clothes all succumbed to choking. Ida's canoe on the wall, new owners' bodies permanently soaking. Kitchen utensils missing their targets, ever vigilant and ready. Appliances bought never plugged in, securely or steady. As for me, I was given a baby monitor from there. The sentiment of a gesture was meant with great care. Sinister voices appeared out of nowhere at night. They chant at my baby until I turn on the light. My mind wakes with scorching senses. It smells like something's burning. The thick smell of smoke sets my stomach to aching. Running to my baby's room, I gasp out in surprise. A normal room greets me. No flames lick my eyes. The house never feels hot, just smoky and thick. My subconscious paranoia. Towards me, it's trying to trick. If you bought something from Ida, please run now while you still can. Because today, flame's very real, or licking at my hand.